Hello friends, in this particular video, we will try to understand different type of network management standards. So basically, network management standards comes from the network management models. There are three types of network management models. The first one was OSI model, second one TCP/IP, and third one TMN. With the help of these three models, we all know that there are few protocols which are present in every layer of the model. Protocol means rules and regulations which are used to make our communication much more successful. So with the help of these rules and regulations, when we try to make some communication from one device to other device, then that will be surely successful. Or we can say the efficiency of the transmission for that particular communication is much more greater than that of without using any protocol. So that the protocol will play an important role in every model of communication. Now, protocol lie at a particular layer. Different layer contains different protocol, and depending on them, there are different rules and regulations set for every type of layer of every type of model. So that it is very important to understand the network management standards. In this particular network management standards, we will try to understand use of protocol also in that particular layer so that we are getting that network management standard. Let us start with first standard, which is known as OSI/CIMP. Now, CIMP is the name of the protocol. It is nothing but Common Management Information Protocol. And it lies in which model of the communication? In the OSI. So the name of this network management standard is OSI/CIMP. It is International Standard Organization deals with 7 layers of OSI model. We all are familiar with OSI model. That is, there are 7 layers of the OSI model. For example, physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. So this CIMP deals with all the 7 layers of the OSI model. It is most object-oriented protocol. So the type of the protocol is what? It is programmable or unprogrammable? It is object-oriented or not? That we have to write in this particular point. So here we require to write it is object-oriented protocol. It is well-structured and well-layered. The structure of this particular protocol is well in the model which is known as OSI. It consumes large resources in implementation, management of data communication network in local area network and wide area network. Now, the main point is, if there are few advantages of this particular CIMP, then where we can use it and how we can use it? Networks are of many types. That is nothing but local area network, wide area network, global area network and all. So, where we can use this particular network management standard? This is the main question. So, now we have to move for the application of this particular standard. And in this application, we have to understand where we can use CIMP. CIMP, that is Common Management Information Protocol, this we can use to design local area network, that is nothing but LAN, and wide area network, that is nothing but WAN. So LAN can be of 10 km and WAN range is from 10 km to 100 km. So how can we use them to design two types of networks? We are able to use CIMP. So it is suitable with the help of this protocol, which is known as Common Management Information Protocol. Summary of this particular network management tool is It can deal with all the 7 layers of OSI model, and you can write down all the names of the 7 layers. Second, it is object-oriented protocol. It is well-structured and well-layered. Well-layered means we can easily say the fixed position of this particular protocol in the layer of a particular model. Next one, the drawback is it consumes large resources, but the use is once it will consume large resources, it is able to cover the large area of network also, so that it can be used to develop LAN, that is local area network, as well as WAN, that is known as wide area network. And as it is suitable for all these things, it is known as common management information protocol. So this is about the first network management standard, which is known as OSI/CIMP. The next management standard is SNMP. This is also written as Internet/SNMP. Now, who tried to design this? Internet Engineering Task Force Industry Standard developed this protocol. This is known as IEFT. It is originally intended or developed for the management of internet protocol or internet components and currently adopted for wide area network. So again, the main question, where we can use it? We can use them to develop wide area network, that is known as WAN. It is easy to implement than that of the other protocol, hence known as simple network management protocol. The long form of SNMP is simple network management protocol. Why it is known as simple network? Because if we are going to compare them with the other all protocols, then we can understand that it is very easy to implement. Implementation in the two ways, planning and designing, combinedly known as implementation. So where we can plan to use this particular protocol for the wide area network, that is the network which has a range from 10 km to 100 km is nothing but wide area network. So we can use it in WAN, and it is very easy to implement, that is design, than that of the other protocols, hence known as the simple network management protocol. Just like our previous protocol, which was developed by OSI model, like that this is developed by IEFT, and hence initially it was used for the internet components. To design of internet components was the first step of SNMP, so that it is known as Internet/SNMP also. If we are going to use it for the other purpose, then we can only use the name of the standard, such as SNMP, and the application is WAN application. The next one is TMN. This is nothing but Telecommunication Management Network Protocol. The use of the TMN, that is, if we are having the two different type of models in our hand, which are known as OSI and TCP/IP, and with respect to that, all protocols we are having in our hand, then also we have to move for TMN. Why? Because there are two aspects of communication. First one is regarding the network provider, and second one is regarding service provider. When there is only one network provider and one service provider in our hand, then every network and their collaboration is depend on the service provider. So that once the service provider will get fails, then what happen about our network? Our network will become failure. So in this particular situation, the two aspects like this, and hence we required some answer for such kind of situations, which are known as the critical situations. The answer is the protocol, which is known as TMN, and with respect to that, the model which was developed, which is again known as TMN. So who defined this particular protocol? IUT defined Telecommunication Management Network Protocol. It is based on OSI network management. So the basics of TMN also is nothing but what? OSI. It addresses both network and administrative aspects of management. Now, The main thing is that what it means by network and what it means by administrative aspects of management. I already told you there are two aspects of communication. One is nothing but the network provider and one is nothing but the service provider. Instead of these two things, the third important thing which is present in the network is nothing but network elements. So whenever any network is dependent on the service provider, once the service provider will get failure, the whole network will get failure. When the network is not dependent on network provider and service provider, then the network output is dependent on the connection and communication of network element in between them. So, whenever we are talking about the network aspects, then it is related with network element and their connection and communication. Whenever we are talking about administrative aspects, it is depend or it is related with that particular element in whose hand the network is controllable. That means it can be NOC, network provider can be two type. One is NMS and other is NOC. That is nothing but network management system and network operation center. So, TMN is the protocol, that means the set of rules and regulation who will give you the answer for both the aspects of network management and administrative management. And hence, this particular protocol will play an important role in the communication when there are critical situations which are beyond the hand or the limit of the protocols which are in the OSI model and in the TCP/IP model, then we can go and use such kind of protocols. So the most important network management standard, which is known as TMN and which was defined by IUT. The next one, which is IEEE, the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. This define IEEE protocol. It is adopted internationally. It addresses management of land or local area network. That is, again, the application of IEEE is nothing but LAN and metropolitan area network. That is nothing but MAN. So LAN and MAN, these are the two things which are in the hand of this particular protocol. That means we can design and plan such kind of huge area of network with the help of IEEE. It adopts OSI standards significance. It deals with the first two layers of OSI reference model. So, OSI reference model and its first two layers are nothing but physical layer and data link layer. So, these two models, first two, that means OSI model start from physical layer and that will end to application layer. So the first two lowest layers are nothing but what? Physical layer and data link layer, in which raw material or the raw data is present, which we require to convert into the electrical signal or the digital signal. So IEEE is used for designing the LAN, that is local area network, and MAN, that is metropolitan area network, and it can develop or design these two kinds of things with the help of the significance which are related to the first two layers of OSI model. Here we have to understand, any protocol, though it is from OSI model, though that is from TCP/IP, or though it is from TMN model, then also everything is based on the basic structure of the communication, which is known as OSI model. So every time any protocol which we require to understand in between the network management standard, then also we require to deal it with the OSI layer and hence with respect to their particular protocol. The last one is web-based management. It is based on web technology, web server from management system. Web browser for network management station is able to use the web-based management protocol, or we can say web-based management standard. Two technology are used here, which are known as web-based enterprise management. This is the first. That means WBEM and Java Management Expert, JME. These two technology are going to use such kind of network management standard, which is known as web-based management standard. Nowadays, Desktop Management Task Force has chosen the Microsoft Object-Oriented Management model. So, what is the application of this particular protocol? That is nothing but the Desktop Management Task Force, which is going to select the Microsoft Object-Oriented Management model. Here we can use the web-based management. How can we use them in any software or tool? Because it is nothing but the technology is the combination of two types of things, which are known as WBEM and JME. So web-based management is used to design any object-oriented software, and nowadays it is nothing but the application of that particular network management standard. So in this way, we try to understand few network management standard. The first one, with the help of OSI model, which is known as CIMP. The second one, with the help of internet model, which is known as SNMP. The third one, with the help of TMN model, the network management standard name is TMN itself. The next one is IEEE. And the last one, which can give us the object-oriented programming, which is known as web-based management. In all these five network management standard, the common thing is every time it can deal with the OSI, that is nothing but the basic structure of language or of communication, which is used to develop communication, and hence every time we have to use all the standards or the layers, and we require to deal the protocol and data types with the OSI layer structure. Here the SNMP is mostly used because it is very simple to design it, to implement it, and hence the name itself is SNMP, that is Simple Network Management Protocol. Every protocol and our network management standard will play an important role with the different applications. The applications are specially depend on the different type of area of network. Then the area can be LAN, it can be WAN, it can be MAN, GAN, etc. So while designing the different types of area network, we require to use such kind of protocols, and hence every standard is able to classify it into the different area of network and their applications. So with the help of all these things, we require to revise or remember the network management standard along with their applications and their particular layer and their position. Thank you.